You know, we're too smart to argue with each other. I'm greater than you. No, I'm better than you. We're way too religious to do that. We just do that by pointing to somebody else's flaws. It's the more subtle way of saying, I'm better than you. Anyway, let's stop meddling and move on here. But the disciples, what did Jesus do? He immersed them in this atmosphere of presence and power, used them in significance in a glorious way, the way he had designed for them to live. But in doing so, it dialed up stuff in their hearts that they didn't know was there. Peter was shocked to find out he would deny the Lord. He was absolutely convinced he would last when everybody else fell. And yet he was the one who denied Jesus. What happens? In these moments where there's pressure, pressure isn't always negative, but pressure isn't always added because of problems. Sometimes pressure is added because of the miraculous, of the way God uses us, because of the understanding we receive. There's just this stuff that comes on our life, and the weightiness of God's work in us reveals fractures. It doesn't cause fractures, it reveals fractures. Why? The Lord never does that to shame us. He never does that as punishment. He always does it so that we can see what he sees. Because if I can see what he sees, then I can confess. And confession basically means to agree with God. So the weightiness of God's work in my life reveals a fracture. Maybe it's a fracture in my thinking. Every time I get in this pressure situation, I just start criticizing myself. Or every time I get in this pressure situation, I want to withdraw from people. Or every time I get in this pressure situation, I blame other people around me instead of taking responsibility. Whatever it might be, that weightiness of whether it's blessing or whether it's responsibility, it reveals fractures. Why? It's so that I can come into agreement with God. I see that, Lord. I see that I have that tendency to beat myself up when this pressure comes. Please forgive me because I believe things about me you don't believe about me, and it's got to change. What is he doing? He's in his mercy. He's revealing fractures so that we can come into agreement, because once we see it and we come into agreement, the confession releases the capacity to forsake. That was really good news right there. The confession. I see it. Oh God, I beat myself up every time this pressure comes. I'm tired of it. I know you revealed that so that I confess it. I agree with you. There's a fracture in my makeup that blames me for everything, and I know it's not right. And I'm confessing my self-centeredness, because don't think it's anything other than you blame you every time something is wrong. It's a reverse arrogance and pride. Face it, call it for what it is, because I'm still the focus of my attention. God, please forgive me for this subtle pride that has robbed me of so many things in my life. I'm through with it. I'm finished with it. And by your grace, I step into thinking differently about me now because of what you said over me. So there's that confession. We forsake. He actually releases in the confession the divine capacity to forsake, to leave what has trailed behind you all this time.